Good morning, church.
Morning, church.
Good morning, church.
Good morning, church family.
Good morning, Christ Church.
Good morning, 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 church.
Good morning. Welcome to Christ United Methodist Church online. We are so glad that you have chosen to worship with us this morning. We hope that you are blessed by the service, and we can't wait to see you face to face. On behalf of the congregation, we welcome you. We bless you. We behold the Christ in you. Please join me in the call to worship. As we gather today, the word reminds us that God is spirit, and they who worship God should do so in spirit and in truth. With our joys and concerns, our worries and dreams, our questions and longings, we come together in faith, seeking answers in God's holy word. So, in faith, we pray. With love, we praise. And with hope in Christ, the living word, we worship God, who is our refuge and our strength. Please join me in singing the opening hymn. The lyrics will appear on the screen.
Thank you.
again to me wonderful words of life. Lead me more of the beauty, see wonderful words of life. Words of life and beauty, teach me faith and duty. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Christ the Blessed One gives to all wonderful words of life. Sing the list of the loving call, wonderful words of life. Also freely given, calling us to heaven. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Sweetly echo the gospel call, wonderful words of life. Offer pardon of peace to all, wonderful words of life. Jesus, only Savior, sanctified forever. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life.
Please pray with me. God, we do delight in your ways and find refreshing in your spirit. Join us here today. Guide us through the exclamation of your word, the singing of your praises, and the joining of hearts and hands in mission. Nourish our faith so that we may bear fruit that witnesses to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Our first scripture reading will be taken from Psalm chapter 1, verses 1 to 3. The truly happy person doesn't follow wicked advice, doesn't stand on the road of sinners, and doesn't sit with the disrespectful. Instead of doing those things, these persons love the Lord's instruction, and they recite God's instruction day and night. They are like a tree replanted by streams of water, which bears fruit at just the right time, and whose leaves don't fade. Whatever they do succeeds. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. If your children are not already around the computer, I invite you to give them the best seat in the house. This is their special time. Let's sing Where Children Belong as they get settled.
This is where children belong. Welcome as part of our worshiping throng. Honor God's word, let the cup bring the song. This is where children belong.
Good morning, young disciples. I hope that you are all doing well and that you all had a wonderful week. Now, last week, we talked about the importance of prayer and how prayer is a two-way conversation between us and God. This week, we're going to talk about the importance of Scripture and the importance of studying the Word of God. Now, when I was growing up, my mother used to say, "Birds of a feather flock together." Now, usually, she said this whenever a conversation came up where she was warning me against becoming too friendly with children that she did not believe would be a good influence on me. Now, every time she would say it, I would roll my eyes, and I just believed that she was trying to control me, and I didn't trust that she trusted me to pick my own friends, and I wanted to choose my own friends. Have you ever encountered that with your parents? I'll bet you have, because whether I liked it or not, I believe that many times my mom was right, and our scripture for this morning supports my mom's understanding that birds of a feather do flock together. Now, it does matter who you hang out with. Now, why do you suppose that it matters who we hang out with? Now, do they influence us from time to time? Of course they do. Do we sometimes follow the crowd when we shouldn't? Regretfully, yes, sometimes we do. And when we hang out with the wrong people, we sometimes start to think the wrong things just like them. We start to think that some things are okay when they really are not. God knows this about our human nature. Our parents know this. That is why we are warned not to hang out with the wrong crowd. The scripture says that we are on our way to a happy life when we avoid following bad advice, standing by when others are doing things that are wrong, and by sitting with people who are disrespectful. Instead, the psalmist tells us that we are to spend our time learning and reciting God's word, which is found in scripture, because when we do, we become strong, we become fruitful, and we become successful. When we read scripture, we learn about God and about ourselves. We learn what we should do and what we should not do. We also learn who to keep close and who to be careful around. Because if friends can influence us to do bad things, they can also influence us to do good things. And so hanging around with the right people is as important as not hanging around with the wrong people. Now, we want to find people that are good people and will help us to make good decisions. And they will influence us to do good things. Because birds of a feather flock together. Let us pray. Gracious and holy God, we thank you, O Lord, for your word, which is a light and a lamppost for our feet that leads us in the way of righteousness that leads to you. We pray, O God, for our young disciples, that you fill them with your wisdom and discernment to know who are good influences on them and who are the bad influences on them. God, help us to be the type of people that leads others into goodness with you. Help us, O Lord, to read our scriptures, to meditate on them, to learn from them, and then to go out into the world and spread the good news to those who are already on the good path and those who, O Lord, are on the wrong path. Use our young disciples and use us, O God. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Amen.
Holy Father, love me still. I am falling from your will. I am broken, hear my humble cry, my cry. Take my life and make it yours, Lord. I have wandered for so long, tired and weary on my own. In your arms I know I'm home, oh God, my God.
This week, we continue in our sermon series, Purple Theory, with our next spiritual exercise, reading, studying, and meditating scripture. Reading and meditating on scripture lay the foundation for Christian life. And so now we pray together. Holy Spirit, open our hearts to receive your word. Reveal to us the good news and enable us to trust in the promise of salvation that is found in Jesus Christ. Amen.
From brushing your teeth to doing the daily crossword puzzle, have you ever noticed how certain habits create the rhythm of your day? We all have certain things we do in our quest to keep our bodies and minds healthy and poised to tackle the challenges ahead of us. But there are habits that can help our spiritual health too. As springtime comes, let's improve our spiritual health and grow closer with God this Lent by exercising spiritual disciplines.
Hampton Sides wrote a book about Kit Carson, called Blood and Thunder, the epic story of Kit Carson and the conquest of the American West. In the book, we learn that Kit Carson left home in rural Missouri at 16 to become a mountain man and trapper in the West. He filled the role of a scout for wagon trains and the U.S. Cavalry. To do this effectively, he had to learn the different trails of the West and be able to understand the terrain, both its benefits and its dangers. Because of this, history documents in multiple places where he was able to save expeditions, a wagon train, and even the U.S. Cavalry because of his knowledge of the trails. Some of the trails were developed and others were not, but he had the savvy to know what to do, whether it was traveled or not. In one chapter, The Pathfinder, it describes how, because of Kit Carson's knowledge of some of the mountain passes in what was then the Mexico territory of California, he was able to save an entire expedition that just a few years later resulted in the deaths of the Donner Party in the Sierra Nevadas. Hampton Sides writes this about Kit Carson. As a tracker, he was unequaled. He knew from experience how to read the watersheds, where to find grazing grass, what to do when encountering a grizzly. He could locate water in a desert arroyo and strain it into potability. In a crisis, he knew tricks for staving off thirst, such as opening the fruit of a cactus or clipping a mule's ear and drinking its blood. Some might say that Kit Carson mastered the art of choosing the right roads to travel. Sisters and brothers, what our scripture is telling us this morning is that we are to watch our steps and make wise choices as we travel the roads of life. We, like Kit Carson, have to learn the trails of life and how best to navigate them. And the psalmist tells us that a commitment to reading and meditating on scripture is the main tool in our arsenal to choose and stay on the road that leads to happiness. To entice us to choose the happy trail, our psalmist paints the happy life with images stolen from paradise. Verdant with plant life, nourished by gentle waters, seasonably fruitful, and unfailingly prosperous. They tell us that the journey down the wrong path is progressive. It begins with following wicked advice, advances to standing on the road with sinners, and culminates with making ourselves so comfortable on that wrong road that we sit down and make a home with the disrespectful. They are telling us that the more we sin, the easier it gets. And if we are not careful, we may find the adage, if you lie, you will cheat. If you cheat, you will steal. If you steal, you will kill, could become a self-fulfilling prophecy. Bernie Madoff didn't start off embezzling millions of dollars from individuals. He began with a lie, followed by cheating on the paperwork that showed the financial breakdown of the monies that he was entrusted to invest. And finally, his lying and cheating led to the death by suicide of one of his investors who reportedly lost $1.4 billion in Madoff's Ponzi scheme. If you lie, you will cheat. If you cheat, you will steal. And if you steal, you will kill. And before you know it, you will look around and see that you are on the wrong road. And the road leads not to happiness, but to death. But the psalmist offers us an alternate route. They say instead of taking the road that leads to death, we can choose the road that leads to happiness. The Hebrew word Esher, which has the idea of happiness or blessedness. Esher comes from the Hebrew word ashar, which in its root means to be straight or to be right. Happy or blessed is the person who speaks this happiness and blessedness, the contentment in the life of the man or woman who is right or straight with God. The righteous person will be a blessed or happy person. The psalmist tells us that the road to happiness or blessedness is marked by a love of the Lord's instruction and the study and recitation of God's word, both day and night. According to the psalmist, the righteous person ponders the word of God. They don't just hear it and forget it. They think about it night and day. As Christians, we should love and meditate on God's word. There's no getting around it, folks. As Christians, we must have a strong scripture study life. Now, don't get it twisted. Psalm 1 does not mean that happiness can be reduced to a mechanical process of following a set of rules for which one is duly rewarded. Instead, happiness or blessedness is a dynamic process that involves, no, requires constant meditation upon God's will, in order to ascertain what God would have us do in every situation. In short, Jesus would later summarize the Torah. Happiness comes from discerning what it means at all times and in all places to love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and your neighbor as yourself. Scripture is life-giving and life-sustaining. It is not a quick fix or a fad diet. Studying scripture is a lifestyle change. There's beauty and grace in the midst of it, even when it's really difficult. Verse 3 gives the image of trees planted by streams of water. We can think of Scripture as the stream and the soil that we plant ourselves by and in. With time and consistency, Scripture helps us to realign our lives, to be rooted and to grow. Imagine a tree that is always being uprooted and moved from place to place, or that was only ever given small amounts of water. It would never take root, and it would never grow. It would never yield fruit, and it would ultimately die. When we meditate on Scripture, we find our story within. Both our triumphs and our screw-ups are all in that Bible. It is not the ancient or irrelevant text, because God, who wants to be present with us through Scripture, the discipline of reading, studying, and meditating Scripture is a life-sustaining one. As we continue in this Lenten journey of exercising spiritual disciplines, I ask you to consider which road you have chosen. Are you on the progressive road that leads to destruction? Are you listening, walking, and sitting with those who have committed themselves to wickedness, sin, and disrespect? Or are you on the road that leads to healthy, fruit-bearing, and successful life? If you're on the right road, keep going. Keep reading and contemplating Scripture. Keep loving God and your neighbor. Keep seeking God's face in all of your decisions, both big and small. And if you look around and find out that you are on the wrong road, if you are surrounded by liars and cheats, if you are sitting in seats with the disrespectful, it is not too late to turn around, not too late to answer God's call, to immerse yourself in her word and taste and see if the Lord is good. Jesus, whose very life and death warns us that we will not have a simple life. We will not avoid unease and strife. We won't remain ignorant of ill, but if we are faithful, we can be happy still. And the road that leads to happiness, according to the psalmist, is strewn with love and the study of Scripture. So let's get to it. I invite you to join me in our daily meditation with the Lenten devotional that includes Scripture, or create your own plan. I currently try to read 5 chapters each day. Perhaps you can find an amount that works for you. 1 verse a day is better than no verse a day. Every bit helps build our endurance and our strength, and it draws us farther along the road that leads to happiness. Amen.
Please join me as we pray the prayers of the people. Trusting in God's promises, let us pray for the world and for our needs, saying, Holy God, hear our prayer. God, you blessed Abraham and Sarah and promised to make them the ancestors of many nations. In Jesus Christ, you have opened your covenant to everyone who lives by faith in you. For the descendants of Abraham and Sarah, both Jews and Christians, that they may trust in your promise, dwell together in peace, and be a sign of your abiding love. Holy God, hear our prayer. God, Jesus, your Son, called disciples to follow his way of sacrificial love. For all pastors and teachers, that they lead the church by humble example, take up their cross in faithful service, and live for the sake of the gospel. Holy God, hear our prayer. God, your reign encompasses all the earth. Though many do not remember your gracious sovereignty, for peace among the nations, for the integrity within governments, that your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Holy God, hear our prayer. God, you hear the cry of the poor. You satisfy the hungry with good things, for the poor and oppressed, that they may find deliverance, and for all who voluntarily take up the cross of self-denial to serve the poor and alleviate human misery. Holy God, hear our prayer. God, you know the needs of the afflicted, and you hear their cries. For those who suffer illness in mind or body, that they may find relief from suffering and be restored to wholeness. Holy God, hear our prayer. Grant these prayers, Holy God, by your grace. Stir up in us the will to seek out your kingdom with the dedication of our lives in ministry to the world, for the sake of the gospel of Jesus Christ, through whom we pray the prayer he taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. On this second Sunday of Lent, you are encouraged to commit yourself to the practice of studying God's Word. Alongside your searching the Scriptures, you are invited to consider the gift you will bring that will be used to nourish and refresh our congregation, our community, and our world. God, you have given us all that we have. In faithfulness to your word, we return to you a small portion of what you have given us. We pray that these offerings will be pleasing to you. May they help us bear witness to the living word, Jesus, who offered up his life for us. Amen.
From brushing your teeth to doing the daily crossword puzzle, have you ever noticed how certain habits create the rhythm of your day? We all have certain things we do in our quest to keep our bodies and minds healthy and poised to tackle the challenges ahead of us. But there are habits that can help our spiritual health too. As springtime comes, let's improve our spiritual health and grow closer with God this Lent by exercising spiritual disciplines.
The mission team will be collecting gift cards and donations for the Easter holiday for families in need. Gift cards can be purchased through Sally Trainer. Monetary donations are always welcome and can be done through Zelle, PayPal, or by mailing a check to the church. Please don't fail to mention Shepherd's Angels in the comment section. And if you have any questions, please contact Laureen Cholish at BUCCS411@AOL. And I want to thank you for your support of this ministry. It is with great sadness that I share that we have lost the Reverend Junius Dotson, the author of Soul Reset, to eternity. He passed away this past week after a bout with pancreatic cancer. We mourn his loss, but we celebrate with him the new life he now enjoys with Christ. In honor of his life and legacy of caring for the body of Christ, we will continue in our book study and hopefully learn from his example and share what we have learned with others. If you are not a member of a small group, please join me on Wednesday evening following evening prayer at 7:30 p.m. on Zoom. I hope to see you there. Now, small groups are still going strong, and I invite you to join in. There's so much good things going on in these groups, and I want you to join your sisters and brothers in faith for friendship, fellowship, and fun. Please contact me at ronell.cumc@gmail.com if you would like to join a small group. And please join me before or following service for our combined coffee half hour. Come through at 9:30 for a quick chat, a cup of joe, and a catch-up session. I hope to see you there. And you may also join us in prayer on Wednesday evenings on Facebook Live at 7 p.m. It is there that we pray for those we love and for our world. And if you have not done so already, please like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram and Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube and Vimeo channels. And now for our charge and final blessing. Happy are those who choose their path. I will follow Jesus. Be careful where you put your step. God will be your guide. I will be a tree growing by a stream. God's Spirit is like fresh water. I will grow good fruit and grow strong, and God will watch over me. Disciples of Jesus, do not shun the way of the cross, but follow wherever our Lord may lead. And may the blessings of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit uphold you on the way. As always, stay safe, stay strong, and stay in love with God and your neighbor. Please have a blessed week.
Amen. Amen. Ah.